unto the Lord, and call it Jehovah Shalom. Praise the living God. Amen. One more time, tell your brother or your sister by your side, Jehovah Shalom, restore your peace in Jesus' name.
Jehovah Shalom, restore your peace in Jesus' name.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
No matter the situation that we are passing through, no matter all the troubles that you have been facing in your lifetime or in this life, the word of God comes today unto you, and the word of God says, peace unto you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I start from the book of Judges. If you have your Bible, please open with me to the book of Judges, chapter 6, and verse 10. I read from King James. Amen?
Amen.
If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
And I said unto you, I am the Lord your God. Fear not the gods of the Amorites, in whose land ye dwell, but ye have not obeyed my voice. Praise the living God. Why some of us might be wondering, I have been a Christian and I have been praying to my God, and still there is no peace. And the Lord says, there is peace for the people of God, but the problem is that we refuse to obey to the word of God. Praise the living God. This word that we have been rejecting, the Christian of our generation, the word we have been rejecting has been existing from the day one of the creation. Which the book of John chapter 1 verse 1 says, in the beginning was this word, and this word was with God. And eventually, this word became God. And when we are reading from the book of Genesis chapter 1, God has been working with this word. Praise the living God. And the angel said unto Gideon, the problem is like there is no peace. There is peace, but we have refused to listen to the voice of the Most High God. Praise the living God. And when we start listening to the voice of the Most High God, things will change. An abundance of peace will start to come and reign in our life again. Praise the living God. Please, if you have the Bible with you, open to the book of John chapter 14. John chapter 14 verse 27. John chapter 14 verse 27. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
I read, peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth. Give I unto you, but let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When Christ was talking to I and you, the assurance that he made to us is this: I'm giving my peace to you people, and my peace I have left with you. I'm no longer taking this peace away from you. Only if you will listen to me, only if you will follow me faithfully. Praise the living God.
Amen.
I don't care about the high mountains that you have been upon, it caused so much trouble or temptations. No matter what is the temptations, no matter what is the problem, but the word of God is saying, peace I have bring unto you, and this peace I will never take it from you. And this peace is not the peace the way the world gives. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Sometimes when we need peace, we decide to take a couple of glasses of alcohol, and perhaps if I give us a little peace, maybe for a short time. Sometimes we go try to hang out with friends so that we can have peace within ourselves. But when you realize it very well, you see that it lasted just for a couple of minutes or seconds or hours, it will vanish. And Christ is talking to I and you. The peace that I have come to give you is not such peace that will last just for a limited time. But my peace is everlasting peace. And therefore, he said finally, do not be afraid. Praise the living God.
Mm-hmm.
No matter the situation that you have been passing through, and the word of God today comes to I and you and say, do not be afraid. Remember, we are still in the chain of prayers. It is still period of our prayers till the end of this year. We are not working according to what we try to research, but what the Holy Spirit tries to give to I and you to share. So the word of God today is this: do not fear about the situation that you are passing through, about the sickness that you have been struggling with, and you believe there is no hope. But with our God, there is hope. What I'm assuring you, there is hope with this God. In the book of John chapter 11, where Lazarus, our brother, died, and the brother and the sisters, they are crying. And when they met our Lord Jesus Christ, he said, this situation, in John 11, verse 4, he said, this situation is just to glorify the name of the living God. Praise the living God. Amen. And when you move further to verse 43, 44, and 45, he commanded Lazarus, Lazarus, come ye forth, because that place is not your portion. Praise the living God. Amen. Therefore, touch anybody by your side and say, that sickness is not your portion. Is it your mother? Amen. The word of God is saying, your mother will not die in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
I want you to understand the power of our God and the power of the peace that God is bringing unto I and you. But the problem is this, you have to talk to God that this is exactly what I need. I need this peace. Perhaps you might have lost your peace in the day past because of sin. Remember the book of Judges chapter 10 and verse chapter 6, verse 10 says that the Lord is able to deliver them, that because of the Amorites is not God. Are they chasing you with different gods that you don't know their names? Those gods are no gods. That was the word of God. In verse 10, he says, the gods of the Amorites, is it the gods of Buddhism? Is it the god of this land? Is it the god of Africa? They cannot do you anything.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
If those gods are powerful, they would have taken me since. But because they are not powerful, and the word of God says, why these things are befalling us is because we refuse to listen to the word of God. And what is that word of God? Ask yourself, what is that word of God? But I will give you the simplest answer. The word of God is anything that your mind tells you, this is right. Know that it's a right word of God. And when it says, this is wrong, know that this thing is wrong. Praise the living God.
Yeah.
We don't need anybody to start teaching you, this is Ten Commandments, this is what Jesus said, this is what Christ said, or Peter said, or Paul said. No. You know what is right, I know what is right. And we know what is wrong. When you are stealing, are you stealing in an open place?
No.
Praise the living God. When you are taking alcohol that overdoses you, are you taking it in the church?
No.
And when you are trying to steal a woman, do you do that openly? In the club, you do this openly. Not in the church. And those people that are doing it in the church openly, curses will be upon them. Just mark my message. Sometime 3 years ago, a sister was trying to destroy the church of Christ. I was wondering, I don't have time to come and start calling you or coming to your house to tell you what God says. I stand there and I tell you, when I finish telling you, I will go to my house. And she was putting everything upside down because she needed favor. She wanted to satisfy herself. And she was even putting something that is so transparent that we can see her inner body. And she stands here to sing for us. Praise the living God. But when this word came to her, she was so arrogant and stupid enough that she refused. She said nothing will happen. And when something started happening to her, she consulted all the prayer people, and none of them could rescue her. Praise the living God. Today, where is she? Today, where is the marriage? I said it here before it happened. Praise the living God. When you think that you are here to come and joke, or you are here to come and know, say this, see Dixon, because we are doing Arabites together, you are mocking your God. And when the situation comes, no power can save you. Praise the living God. What we are talking about is the serious children of God that need restoration of peace. Have your business been shattered and destroyed? But the word of God today is saying, peace unto you in that business.
Amen.
The book of Psalm 127 says, except the Lord God Almighty come and build up that business, you can do nothing. Except that God start to protect you, you can do nothing. Don't think that when you are having $5,000 in your pocket, you start being arrogant and rude. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Some people have lost $100,000 in this land. Jerry lost equivalent to that amount before he left here. So you have $5,000, he can take it at any time. But when you bring this peace into that $5,000, it becomes $5 million. Praise the living God.
Amen.
What we are talking is about the peace of God. No matter the situation that you have been passing through, and you have been believing that there is no end to this situation, I want you to understand, there is an end. In the book of Judges chapter 6, verse 1 said, and the children of Israel were being humiliated for 7 years. Praise the living God. Your own situation, has it been up to 7 years? It has not been up to 7 years. And in verse 24, the angel of God now gave them victory. When this power of victory was given unto Gideon, they said, as a single man, you will pull down your enemies. Now, go and pull down all your enemies and secure your success in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatsoever is chasing you, the family that every year we lost people in those families, it is not your portion. We need this peace to come back and take absolute control. Because Christ is this peace. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you have the Bible, please let us confirm it from the book of Isaiah 48. Isaiah 48, verse 18. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
Isaiah 48,
amen.
Verse 18. Oh, that thou hast hearkened to my commandments, then had thy peace been as a river, and thy righteousness as the waves of the sea. Praise the living God.
Amen.
God is speaking to I and you. The only problem we have is this: not listening to the word of God. He said, oh, had it been that my people will hearken unto me. Not man, you are not listening to man. Anytime I start teaching you anything that is not in this Bible, please don't listen to those things. But in as much as we are reading things from this scripture, understand that God is the one talking to you. God cannot come down from heaven to talk to you. In the book of Revelation, God says, I have sent my angels to go through the prophets and teach what I've asked them to teach. We understand that so many things has went wrong in the churches. But believe me, we still have churches of Christ. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Churches of Christ, we focus on the word of God. I don't focus on miracle, and I don't even care for miracles. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Don't allow miracle to take our attention. We have some forces that are performing miracles. We have those that are performing magic. When you go to the book of Matthew chapter 24, Christ was warning us that certain people will come and they will start performing miracles in his name. And they will even tell you that they are the Christ. And don't be carried away. One thing is certain, when you understand the word of God, and you understand the power in the word of God, you will be saved. This is the word that brings peace unto the whole world. It's not only unto a man. Praise the living God. When we said about vision, with what spirit are they telling us those visions? Actually, they may tell us something that is true, or something that related to what has been happening to I and you. They may start calling the name of our ancestors that has passed away. But remember last week, when we are studying from the book of 1 Samuel, Samuel went to a woman who is working with a familiar spirit. And in other language, she was called a medium. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And this woman now starts calling all the spirits of Samuel. And such things are existing up to this day. So when you are going to the visioners, you are going to this man or to the other man. My question is this: after all those visions, have your problem been solved? Praise the living God. If you are asking of those that have went to visioners and have went, I tried to go any visioner that I had of when I was very young. But at the end of it, you will get nothing. But my spirit starts coming to peace when I start realizing the word of God.
Amen.
With this word of God, we can communicate with the angels of God. When you study the word of God and you keep the word of God, let me tell you the truth. No evil that will ever befall you. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The message today is peace unto you.
Amen.
As you are praying and struggling, 2015 might not be the best for you. Maybe because the God of peace has not come in. And today, the message is this: try to bring in the God of peace in anything you are doing, so that you will be successful praise and living God.
Amen.
From the one that God created man and woman, he gave us all peace and all comfort. Remember that there was nothing missing. Sickness was not attached. When our father Adam and Eve, when they were enjoying the Garden of Eden, the scripture did not account of any sickness. The scripture did not account of any failure. There wasn't any disappointment. There wasn't any breakage of hope. There wasn't any evil. There wasn't any evil spirit even. There wasn't any problem at all. They are not even struggling for what they will eat. Praise the living God. Because the God of peace is in them. And that peace was with them. And the peace started making all sense to be so nice for them. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And that peace is what we need to come in our own lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But the scripture proceeded in saying, but from that day, that Eve, our mother, she's our mother. From the day that Eve decided to step aside from the word of God, and calamity started coming in. Demons started chasing them. Downfall started being their portion. Suffering started following them. Sickness started coming. And eventually, the celestial body and power that was given unto them was withdrawn. God did not create human being to be dying. Remember that Adam and Eve, from the beginning, Bible did not say they will die. But from the day, they decided to trespass against the living God. And the scripture said, and death set in. And God now decided to curse them. In the book of Genesis chapter 3, and God said unto Adam, listen to me. You are out of this dust, and you will surely come back to this dust. Because the spirit of the living God has been taken away from him. And the peace of God wasn't with him anymore. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When we go through the word of God in truth and the spirit, no matter the topic, it goes with the righteousness of God. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And Adam now brings us into this great struggle. If you're a man, if you're having if, be careful with your if in your house. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Watch that brother by your side. Be careful of that if.
Be careful of that if.
Are you scared of me? Watch him again. Say, be careful of this. Praise the living God. What if is doing is so much. All the fruit there is not enough for it. Only that one that they ask if don't eat. That is the best for it. Be careful if you are having it. Praise the living God. The word of God moves zigzag. It may come to you zigzag, it may come to me zigzag. Praise the living God. Why you must be careful with Eve is this. In the history of downfall of a man, woman is always the cause. Praise the living God.
Amen.
I'm not talking sisters, you people are very good. I'm saying generally what happened in the scripture. I'm not saying our sisters, because you people have been blessed with Christ. And Christ is in your lives.
We
are all about Eve.
Yes.
The two people are Mary, our mother.
Yes.
You people are Sarah, our mother.
Yes.
Praise the living God.
Yes.
We don't need people like Jezebel. Remember that Ahab was trying to come back to God, and Jezebel said no.
Yeah.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
That was why we must be careful. When we need that peace of God most high. Listening to the voice of God is key number one. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Sisters, don't be offended. Sisters, don't be offended, please.
Yeah.
All the sisters, don't be offended.
Yes.
That is what Bible says, is what I'm trying to interpret. If you have your Bible, please, let us go to the book of Isaiah 26. Isaiah chapter 26. Verse 3. I read. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The promise of God is to keep you to a perfect peace.
Amen.
May God start to restore a perfect peace in your life in Jesus' name. Over your business, our prayer today is this. May God restore a perfect peace in your business in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In your academic careers, let God provide a perfect peace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In your jobs and working places, let there be restoration of a perfect peace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Over your families, we are praying. Let there be a perfect peace in your family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Over your good thoughts that you are having and asking God to bless, let there be a perfect peace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In your stay in this land, we decree today, under the anointing of the Holy Ghost, let there be a perfect peace.
Amen.
In your stay in this land.
Amen.
That you will not fall into temptations of the enemies. Everything that you need, those sickness, oh, we command the sickness to go out of the life of a child of God.
Amen.
Because it is not the portion of a child of God.
Yes,
I will restore a perfect healing peace to come into their lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
When we start to follow this God accordingly, you will understand there are so many benefits in God. As today is prayer of peace, let this peace continue being even unto your families.
Amen.
Anywhere they are in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But remember what the book of Isaiah proceeded in saying. The book of Isaiah says, there is no peace for the
wicked.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
I'm telling you what the Bible says. If we are having wicked desire in our hearts, let us take it out, so that this peace will come and restore that place in Jesus.
Amen.
I don't say you are wicked. And I don't say I'm wicked. I don't know if they say it's wicked.
I'm not.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
In all your endeavors, in all your prayers, the rest of this 2015, let this peace spread in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Even unto 2016, our prayer is, let peace continue to lead us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Unto our brother, Alex, and let the peace come upon her mother's health in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If truly the scripture has said, I'm not the one who is saying it, but truly what the scripture says in Isaiah 53, verse 4 and 5, it says, surely he bears our infirmities and carries our griefs. And verse 5, he says, and by his stripes we are being healed. May your mother be healed by the stripes of Christ Jesus in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And the word of Psalm 107 says, I will send forth my word. And that word is the peace. Is that Jesus Christ? May that word be sent to locate her in any hospital she is.
Amen.
And keep her in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And when we read again, we proceed in the book of Exodus, verse 15:26. And he said, I am the healing God, Jehovah Rapha.
Yeah.
Oh, he said his sickness will not continue in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
Remember in the trouble of Gideon, when this power of peace came unto him, they were so scared because of the situation. When you read the book of Judges chapter 6 very well, you understand it well. They were so scared. And the children of Israel, after planting their crops, the Midianites, the Amalekites, and the Eastern people will come and destroy everything. And they will eat everything. And the children of Israel will start hiding in the caves and in the rocks. And the word of God came unto Gideon and said, peace unto you. I said peace unto you.
Amen.
May that peace come and revive you and pursue you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Word of God may come. It may come at this minute.
Yeah.
But you may start searching for what the word of God will do in your life. Then you may not see it for the next one day, the next 2 days. Don't think that it is not effective. Give God encounter the angel of God. And when God said, I've given you this peace, that same God that rescued your ancestors from the land of Egypt, I'm still the same God. And in chapter 7 of Judges, He asked Gideon, "Now go as a single man." May the angel of God go before you.
Amen.
Let me tell you, no single man, no matter how strong you are, you can't face seven people with weapon. One single man, no matter how strong you are, Gideon as a single man, God commanded him, go and face these people that have terrorized the children of Israel for the full 7 years. And Gideon was scared. And he kept on asking, how could this be? Praise the living God. And God said, this can be. And this can be in your mother's situation in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And when the time comes, the angels of God descended and went and fought that battle. It wasn't Gideon. Praise the living God.
Amen.
That situation that we have been in it, don't allow that situation to drag you into sin. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Come and cooperate so that I will bless your way and bless your life. Never. Mm-hmm. Praise the living God.
Amen.
You can't compromise with your blessings. Where I was working, a little woman like this wanted me to compromise. Praise the living God.
Amen.
I started looking at this little woman. I said, you doesn't know that I have a giant as a wife, even. And you are coming trying, I will do your job, your factory job, and compromise to you, to your house again. Praise the living God.
Amen.
I said, well, let me be seeing how that will be. And when the time reached, I tell her, it's time for closing, I'm going to my house. Give me the money. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And the day she started shouting, fighting, I said, you are fighting for nothing. I'm out of Egypt, no more going back to Egypt.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
Don't be scared over the situation.
Yeah.
Because who is speaking to you is the God that spoke to Gideon and the children of Israel. And that place we called his name. If you have their King James version, you will see it was called Jehovah Shalom. Praise the living God.
Amen.
In the situation of every child of God that we are following their footsteps, God came in and they used to call God one powerful name. When I start calling the name of God, I got what I read from my scripture. In the situation of panicking of Abraham, our father, Abraham called this God. When his nephew was taken captive, he prayed and said, God, will you ever revive and restore my nephew again? And God said, yes, pursue your enemies. Pursue your enemies, never allow them to defeat you. And at the end of the day, in the book of Genesis 14, verse 18, Abraham and Melchizedek, they called Jehovah Elion. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The Most High God. As you are having the Most High God, don't worry about the situation.
Amen.
The message is peace unto you.
Amen.
You must have this your peace.
Amen.
And when God answered Abraham again in Genesis 22, verse 14, he called him Jehovah Jireh. That Jehovah Jireh will provide for you.
Amen.
Abraham hopelessly.
Amen.
He was weeping and shedding tears. I will never see my son again. But then God has a plan. Before your problems, God have a plan over that problem.
Yeah.
You are just disturbing yourself for no reason. As we disturb ourselves, has any solution come?
Yeah.
But Abraham asked God, take absolute control. I cannot do anything. And God provided a sacrificial lamb for him. And when he saw his son coming down from that altar of sacrifice, he called God with tear. He said, Jehovah Jireh has answered me. And when they tried to take his wife, a king tried to take his wife. And God went and fought and restored his wife. He called God again, Jehovah Abraham. Praise the living God. In the scripture, all the names of God that we use is in the scripture. I want you to start to call the name of God. Because this God will fight your battle. Remember David and Goliath. David was a little boy. And the peace of the children of Israel were scattered and destroyed. A single man keep on terrorizing them, taunting them. But David, when he rose, in the book of 1 Samuel 17, verse 47, he said, I come unto you with the name of my God, for this battle is of the Lord. And God fought the battle and gave him victory. I want you to have their peace.
Amen.
Any unsettled mind can never have any solution.
Yes.
Let me tell you the truth. If you are not settled within yourself, if that peace is not within you, you cannot pray. If that peace is not within you, you cannot handle issues. If that peace is not in you, you will not be encouraged. I want you to calm down at this point and take the breath of peace of the Most High God.
Amen.
Amen.
No matter how you think that things have went bad against you,
yes,
it is not bad. For all things worketh for good for those that love God.
Amen.
And that was what happened in the case of Lazarus. Jesus told them, this issue is not an issue of crying, because it is an issue to know the power of God. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The issue you are facing is the issue for you to know the power of God. If you come to this land, you finish telling me this land without testimony, you are missing. Praise the living God.
Amen.
My wife wasn't a strong one again before she came here. She's not even interested in anything church before she came to this land. But from this land, her faith was so strong. No, anything she's doing, she says, that's God that answers me in South Korea. Praise the living God.
Amen.
I want that to be your own case as well.
Amen.
Don't just give up. Our message today is for peace to come. And that's Jehovah Shalom. In that verse 24, it says, that place and that name is there up to today, up to tomorrow. That same Shalom, El Shalom, is still working. May he start working in your life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Before we conclude this message, if you have your Bible, please turn to the book of John, chapter 16, 33. Another person, John, chapter 20, 26. Let's read first, book of John 16, 33. John chapter 16, verse 33.
These things I have spoken unto you, that in me you must have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. Overcome the world.
Praise the living God. God bless you, our dear sister.
Amen.
One of the last words that Christ gave to his people, he says, these things I have spoken unto you. In this world, you must face so many tribulations. But hold your peace. Let your peace be with you. Because Christ has overcome. Praise the living God. As Christ has overcome the situation, he has given victory to you. He has given victory to me. That was why the book of 1 John, chapter 4, verse 4, is saying, little children, you are of God. Fear not, for greater is that God who is in you than what is in the world which is troubling you. And let us conclude our message with John 20, verse 26. I read. John 20, verse 26. And after 8 days, again his disciples were with him, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, and doors were shut, and stood in the midst, and said, peace unto you. Only Thomas refused to accept that peace that day. If your name is Thomas, be careful. Praise the living God. If your name is Brother Thomas, our brother Thomas believe.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
And he said unto them, Thomas did not agree. I don't know the message of today if Thomas agree.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
Because in the morning they were asking him, come and sing for God. He said no. Praise the living God. So that was why I'm confused. I don't know if he agreed. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Okay, have you agreed?
The business that the Messiah of God.
Praise the living God.
It's not the promise of the Bible. The promise here is the difference.
thank you so much. Peace unto you. Say to your brother again, peace unto you.
Peace unto you.
Come to the other person, tell the other person, peace unto you.
Peace unto you.
Please, if you can stand, you stand for time of our prayer, and if you can sit and concentrate, please. The only way we talk to God is through prayers. You cannot see God, but God can see you.